We have accomplished. We have arrived. And we have begun this morning in Jesus, loved by the Father and infilled by the Holy Spirit as the Pauline family. Accompanied by Mary, Queen of the Apostles, Saint Paul, our patron, and hosts of eternal Paulines in heaven, today, as one family, in the care of one shepherd, we blessed James Alberione into heaven. Dear sisters and brothers, this celebration also sees complete its full circle after a year long of activities, symposiums, seminars, contests on the Word of God. Blessed Alberione is acclaimed in the church as someone silent, humble, bursting madly to do something.
Words, wonderful words of life.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
We begin the season of Advent. We wait for the Lord's coming in glory. We prepare ourselves for the day of salvation. And therefore, Advent looks forward. But Advent also invites us to look back, because the Lord has already come in history. As Advent unfolds towards the latter part of the season, we focus our attention more directly on preparing ourselves to celebrate the birth of the Lord Jesus, that wonderful event of God becoming a human being, the Word made flesh. Today we join you, dear members of the Pauline family, as you thank God for your founder, Blessed James Alberione, on the 50th death anniversary of his, that was just 2 days ago. We look back with gratitude to God for the wonderful things that God has done through Blessed James Alberione, for his contribution to the life and the mission of the Church, and for his service to society and the whole of humanity. And at the same time, we look forward also, because his life and his vision inspires all of you to be ready to face the challenges ahead. And just as he faced the challenges of his time, we are invited to prepare ourselves so that the Word of God may continue to be preached, to be proclaimed, that it may enter every heart, every human being. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Kyrie eleison.
Christe
eleison.
Christe
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Let us pray. Grant your faithful, we pray, Almighty God, the resolve to run forth to meet your Christ with righteous deeds at his coming, so that gathered at his right hand, they may be worthy to possess the heavenly kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. The word that Isaiah, the son of Amos, saw concerning Judah and Jerusalem. It shall come to pass in the latter days that the mountain of the house of the Lord shall be established as the highest of the mountains, and shall be lifted up above the hills, and all the nation shall flow to it, and many people shall come and say, Come, let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob, that he may teach us his ways, and that we may walk in his paths. For out of Zion shall go forth the law, and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. He shall judge between the nations and shall decide disputes for many peoples, and they shall beat their swords into plowshares and their spears into pruning hooks. Nation shall not lift up sword against nation, neither shall they learn war anymore. O house of Jacob, come, let us walk in the light of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, make me know your way. Teach me your paths.
Lord, make me know your ways. Lord, teach me your paths.
O Lord, make me know your ways. Teach me your paths. Guide me in your truth and teach me, for you are the God of my salvation.
Lord, make me know your ways. Lord, teach me your paths.
Good and upright, he shows his way to sinners. He guides the humble in right judgment. To the humble, he teaches his ways.
Lord, make me know your ways. Lord, teach me your paths.
All the Lord's paths are mercy and faithfulness to those who keep his covenant and command. The Lord's secret is for those who fear him. To them He reveals his covenant.
Lord, make me know your ways. Lord, teach me your paths. Lord, make me know your ways. Lord, teach me your paths.
Second reading, a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brethren, besides this, you know the time, that the hour has come for you to wake from sleep. For salvation is nearer to us now than when we first believed. The night is far gone, the day is at hand. So then, let us cast off the works of darkness and put on the armor of light. Let us walk properly as in the daytime, not in orgies or drunkenness, not in sexual immorality and sensuality, not in quarreling and jealousy, but put on the Lord Jesus Christ and make no provision for the flesh. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia,
alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia.
With you
and with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
At that time, Jesus said to his disciples, "There will be signs in sun and moon and stars, and on the earth, distress of nations. In perplexity because of the roaring of the sea and the waves, people faint with fear and with foreboding of what is coming on the world. For the powers of the heaven will be shaken, and then they will see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. Now, when these things begin to take place, straighten up and raise up your heads, because your redemption is drawing near. But watch yourselves, lest your hearts be weighed down with the dissipation and drunkenness and cares of this life, and that day come upon you suddenly like a trap. For it will come upon all who dwell on the face of the whole earth. But stay awake at all times, praying that you may have the strength to escape all these things that are going to take place, and to stand before the Son of Man." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The season of Advent is a time of waiting, waiting for the Lord to act. And so we wait. The Lord takes his own time to come. But our waiting is not a passive waiting, so much so that we may fall off to sleep, or that we say, the Lord is taking time, let's go and do something else, something more important right now. The Lord, we don't know when he's going to come. Advent is a time of active waiting, of watching alertly. It involves all our senses, of looking around and reading the signs of the times, of keeping our ears open so that we hear the promptings of the Lord, of our whole being involved and actively waiting. What's happening? What are the changes? What is different now? How do we respond to this situation? We await the coming of the Lord in all his glory. We await the day of salvation. In our opening prayer for the first Sunday of Advent, we said, Lord, give us the grace to run forward to meet your Christ. We're not just waiting. We run forward to meet him with that eagerness, with that enthusiasm. We want to welcome the Lord. What does this consist of, this active waiting? Our liturgy today tells us that it requires two things: to watch and to pray. To watch is to be alert, to use all our senses so that we know what is happening around and are able to interpret and accordingly act. Watching means that our whole being is alert. Today, with the advances in communication, we are able to send images very easily. Within a few seconds, we receive an image. But this was not so years ago. And sometimes when we had to meet someone for the first time, we had to go and welcome that person or maybe greet the person at the airport or the railway station. We would not have a picture of the person, but we had some kind of clue. This person is going to wear these kind of clothes, or this person is tall. And then as you're waiting there for this person, you're looking out. Is this the person? Or maybe that is the one whom I'm waiting for. There is an air of expectancy, an active waiting. And that is what we are called to do in the season of Advent. To be waiting, not passively, but actively. The gospel tells us to watch for the Lord's coming. But Luke also tells us, watch yourselves. Be careful, lest your hearts get so overwhelmed and weighed down by the cares of this life that you forget the main focus. We get complacent and slowly we begin to think, okay, things are okay. I'm not so bad. And maybe we slip into sin, into sinful habits, and we feel that everything is going on fine. We are called to watch ourselves. We are so conscious about watching our weight, watching our diet, watching our exercise routine. Should we not also watch our spiritual progress, our call to holiness? Active waiting means watching for the Lord, watching ourselves, and praying. Luke tells his readers that you have to pray, stay awake and pray all times. Yes, during the season of Advent, we will pray a little more intensely. We will find more occasions to spend time with the Lord. But how can we do what Luke tells us? Stay awake at all times praying. He's inviting us to be in constant communion with the Lord. Yes, we have other important responsibilities to be carried out, but even those become moments of contact with God. Even those, when offered to the Lord, can be occasions of connecting to the Lord. We will have specific times of prayer dedicated to him, but right through our work, we are constantly seeking to do the will of the Lord, to seek his will, to know what he wants of us, and to offer that to the Lord. And therefore, we are called to this prayer at all times, right through the day, right through the night, Luke invites us to pray and to welcome the Lord. Maybe during this time of Advent, we could decide on how exactly we will pray more fervently, more committedly, more dedicatedly, more intensely, and more confidently. Just 2 days ago, Pope Francis addressed the Pauline family on the 26th of November. And he said, with far-sighted vision, your founder knew how to embody for the 20th century the necessity that the Word of God might spread rapidly. By using and appreciating the most effective tools and manners of expression offered by technological progress. Pope Francis recalled the words of Pope St. Paul VI to the Pauline family in 1969, where he praised Blessed Alberione as an untiring apostle who was able to read the signs of the times to find the best ways to reach souls. And then Pope Francis went on to say, continue to live the passion and service embodied by St. Paul. The gospel cannot be lived without passion. The gospel cannot be lived without passion. And then he said, never forget prayer. It is the most important means of communication. And so Pope Francis presents to the Pauline family these two pillars, passion for the gospel and prayer, coinciding precisely with what our readings are saying. Active waiting, wanting or welcoming and eagerly waiting for the Lord to come, and praying at all times. And so we reflect a little further on these two, passion and prayer. Passion was evident in Blessed James Alberione, founding 10 institutes in total, 5 congregations and 5 institutes, including the Pauline Cooperators. We have 3 of these in the Archdiocese of Bombay: the Society of St. Paul for Fathers and Brothers, the Daughters of St. Paul, and the Pious Disciples of the Divine Master. And in each of these ways, the vision of Blessed James Alberione is being carried on. The Pauline family has this special call to spread the gospel message through print, through communication media, at that time radio and television, and today the numerous platforms that are available and are even still further developing. He was a visionary with foresight. He was able to foresee the impact that communication media would have. Even at that time, 100 years ago, he was able to say, this would be something that would dominate so much of our lives. Technology would have such a great impact on people, on society, on the world. In his writings, he says, I identify with Christ. His interests are my interests. His intentions are mine. I speak his words. My doctrine is his. My life is Christ's. I do his work. Or better, he does it in me. Alberione echoes the words of St. Paul in Galatians 2:20. Christ lives in me. He was passionate about this. And this is what he sought to do right through his life. In the early hours of the 20th century, he was there in adoration before the Blessed Sacrament, and he was inspired to dream of a church with new apostles going out to all the nations who would reform laws and schools and literature and press and customs. And he dreamt of new means of the apostolate that would be used well. You are now living out that dream. And we thank God for this great visionary as we honor him on his 50th death anniversary. He said, we carry in our heart the whole world. We are apostles of humanity, apostles of unity. He was very forward-looking in his views with regard to the use of technology and communications, also with regard to the role of women. And he says, today's women must shape today's men. Yes, a great challenge indeed, inviting us to be open, inviting us to look to the future. In the gospel passage, the signs of Jesus' coming seem to be frightening. But that is not the purpose, to put fear in our hearts. Rather, it is to shake us out of our complacency when we think that everything is going fine. Rather, to make us be alert and active because our liberation is at hand. And so Luke goes on to say, hold your heads up high, stand erect, the Lord is coming, do not be afraid. This passion, this desire to welcome the Lord, makes us courageous and bold. And that is what James Alberione was. Ready to face difficulties and challenges and to inspire his sons and daughters to be ready to do the same, to be courageous witnesses of the Lord. We ask for this grace that we be passionate, that we await actively the coming of the Lord by the intercession of Blessed James Alberione. The second characteristic or pillar of his life was prayer. He says, prayer therefore, before everything else, above everything, and the life of everything. Before everything, above everything, the life of everything. While he is known as a person of the media, of modern technology and communication, Blessed James Alberione's vision was intensely Eucharistic. That was the source of his strength. Our piety is first and foremost Eucharistic. You are born of the tabernacle, was what he says. It is here that the Pauline family finds its nourishment. And therefore, through visits to the Blessed Sacrament, which are an act of love but requires also discipline, celebration of the Eucharist, adoration of the Eucharistic Lord, all these are moments of deep intimacy with the Lord. At this Eucharist, we encounter the Lord. We welcome him into our hearts. We prepare our lives. We watch what we are doing so that we can welcome the Lord as he comes. Every Eucharist prepares us for the day of salvation. His dedication to Jesus, the Master, way, truth, and life, was foremost. And we see how this threefold dynamic unfolds in so many spheres of life, in the apostolate, in the church's life, in the church's mission, in prayer, in various ways. James Alberione saw that we serve Jesus, Master, the way, the truth, and the life. I was struck as I read through this book of Father George Kaitholil, at least a few sections of it, of this little pact or exchange or agreement that he and Jacardo made with the Lord. It expresses their deep communion with the Lord and their intimacy. He writes, "Seek first the kingdom of God and its righteousness." Signed, Alberione and Jacardo. And then, the second half, "And all the rest will be added to you." Signed, Jesus, the Father, and the Spirit. He was able to even say, this is what the Lord wants of us. This is what the Lord is calling us. And because he was so closely united to the Lord, he could speak on behalf of the Lord. He could make those words of scripture his very own. All the rest will be added to you. Keep the focus right. Be passionate about the Lord's coming. Strive for the furthering of God's kingdom through the use of technology, through the media, and all the rest will follow. Advent means coming. We are waiting for the coming, not of a friend or a relative or a person whom we have to welcome at the airport. We are waiting for the Lord himself. And the Lord's coming depends on him. It is his kingdom. He will bring it about. He will come at a time when he wishes. We should not be complacent. We are not to be afraid. Like James Alberione, we seek to do his will. We are not to be impatient. The kingdom will come in God's time. But we are to be instruments that will further or prepare the way for the coming of the kingdom. That we will sow the seeds so that God will give the harvest. That we will prepare the way so that the Lord will enter. That we will preach the words so that the eternal word will once again be manifested to the whole of humanity. And so our part is active waiting. Let us then watch and pray. Kindly stand as we profess our faith in God. The Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Prayer of the Faithful. As we celebrate the biblical year of the Pauline family and the feast of the founder on his 50th death anniversary, we thank God for the gift of the Word of God that dwelt amongst us, as well as for the sanctity and the zeal bestowed on James Alberione, the untiring apostle of the media. We pray for all the graces we need in order to strive towards holiness and to proclaim the Word of God with greater zeal. Our response, God of mercy, hear our prayer. Together.
God of mercy, hear our prayer. For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, cardinals, bishops, priests, and all consecrated religious, that they may truly live the gospel values and be zealous evangelizers of the world. We pray to the Lord.
God of mercy, hear our prayer.
For the members of the Pauline family all over the world, and particularly in our country, that on this historic moment, we may rededicate ourselves with greater enthusiasm to read the signs of the times and carry on the legacy left to us by our holy founder. We pray to the Lord.
God of mercy, hear our prayer.
For the pioneers and senior members of the Pauline family who spent their lifetime building up and establishing centers of apostolate with much struggle, bless their labors, reward them with abundant joy in this world and fullness of life in the next. We pray to the Lord.
God of mercy, hear our prayer.
For those engaged in the media of communication in various forms, that they may always uphold the values of truth, justice, and harmony, and never give into falsehood and avarice. We pray to the Lord.
God of mercy, hear our prayer.
That on this first Sunday of Advent, we pray for the grace to remain alert and watchful with prayer, faith, and eager expectation, not only for welcoming Christ on Christmas Day, but for his second and glorious coming on the last day. We pray to the Lord.
God of mercy, hear our prayer.
For the departed Paulines and those departed from our families, that they may be united in heaven with all the angels and saints in their eternal bliss and intercede for us from heaven. We pray to the Lord.
God of mercy, hear our prayer. Thank you, Lord, for the gift of special light from the Eucharist and an exceptional love for the Word of God endowed on Blessed James Alberione. Give us the grace to return to these twin gifts, the Eucharist and the Word of God, and be nourished and enlightened by Jesus our Master, the way, the truth, and the life. We ask this through the same Christ our Lord.
Amen.
जीवन मेरा कृपा हो अर्पण तुझे जो भी मेरा
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, we pray, O Lord, these offerings we make gathered from among your gifts to us, and may what you grant us to celebrate devoutly here below gain for us the prize of eternal redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation. That when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of of your glory, Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna, Hosanna in the Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Until you come again. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, Saint Paul, blessed James Alberione, blessed Timothy, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Oswald, our Bishop, the auxiliary bishops, Bishop John, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are placing deep at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us your peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Seems to be no
May these mysteries, O Lord, in which we have participated, profit us, we pray. For even now, as we walk amid passing things, you teach us by them to love the things of heaven and to hold fast to what endures. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. You don't have to sit down. We thank Bishop John for
beautiful celebration of the Eucharist and his wonderful inspiring message. Soon after the Holy Eucharist, we will have a few minutes to refresh ourselves, and then we begin the family gathering, during which we will have an elaborate vote of thanks.
We ask for God's blessing on all of us. Begin the season of Advent, and we thank the Lord for this great gift of Blessed James Alberione, and pray that his vision may continue through the Pauline family. Your response will be Amen. May the Almighty and merciful God, by whose grace you have placed your faith in the first coming of his only begotten Son and yearn for his coming again, sanctify you by the radiance of Christ's advent and enrich you with his blessing.
Amen.
As you run the race of this present life, may he make you firm in faith, joyful in hope, and active in charity. So that rejoicing now with devotion at the Redeemer's coming in the flesh, you may be endowed with the rich reward of eternal life when he comes again in majesty.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Stella del cielo,
Alberione,
uomo di Dio, conta gramelli di sabbia, così sarà la tua famiglia. Amen, amen, amen. Eccomi, Signore. Eccomi, Signore, come l'Apostolo Paolo prescelto, annuncerò il tuo Vangelo. Eccomi, Maestro, Pastore, se tu la via, la vita e la verità.
Guarda le stelle del cielo,
Alberione, uomo di Dio, conta granelli di sabbia, così sarà la tua famiglia. Amen, amen.
The wonders you have wrought in blessed Alberione, a marvel of our times, in whom you have given gifts sublime. Small in stature and frail in health, but not in hidden strength and birth, untiring was he in pursuit of his goal, to give Christ our Master to the world. We praise and we thank you, Lord, for the wonders you have brought in blessed Alberione, a marvel of our times.
A humble man, yet humble Lord,
sad at the service of the world to the signs of time. Ever, O Lord, we praise and we thank you, Lord, for the wonders you have wrought in blessed Alberione, a marvel of our time, in whom you'll give and gifts sublime.
Hello. Hello, there is a special request from our Father Provincial, Father. Yes. In view of the new threat from the new variant of the coronavirus, all of us are requested to wear the mask in this hall. We don't want to be a threat to our neighbor. So please, throughout the program, kindly wear the mask.
okay. Stand. Start. Hey, Peter. Hey, Peter. What's going on there?
Hey, Maria. Why are you so excited? It's heaven, not St. Paul's Book Center. Come on, relax. Tell me.
Can you hear a noise and celebration out there?
Noise? Oh, yes. I can hear. Can you hear?
No.
What could that be? Looks like there is a great feast on earth.
Sister Jolie and Sister Scholastica have also joined from the earth for this celebration.
Oh, let me check. Oh yes, it is the 50th birthday of the founder, Blessed James Alberione. And you and I are assigned to do the announcements.
Oh really?
Oh, let's hurry up. Chalo. Music on, please. Chalo, hurry, hurry, come on.
It happens. Your Lordship, Bishop John, Provincial Superiors, Fathers, Brothers, Sisters, and Pauline Cooperators.
A hearty welcome to each one of you to this 50th Heavenly Birthday celebration of one miracle short of sainthood, Blessed James Alberione.
Here is Sister Shiji, a proud daughter of St. Paul.
This is Reynold, a beloved son of St. Paul. And we are your crew for today's flight.
Airbus Alberione Y50. Kindly fasten your seatbelts and enjoy this flight. Please turn off all personal electronic devices, including laptops and cell phones.
Thank you for choosing Airbus Alberione. Enjoy your flight.
Brothers and sisters, well wishers, Blessed Alberione always wanted his children to be hospitable and far-sighted. While you all enjoy the welcome drink, some of you are still drinking. Father Joe, the captain of the day, is here from the capital to welcome you all and give the keynote. Over to Father Joe.
A very good morning to all of you. Most Reverend Bishop John, Reverend Father Varghese, the Provincial Superior of the Society of St. Paul, Sister Celine, the Provincial Superior of the Pious Disciples of the Divine Master, Sister Arul Mary Susai, the Provincial Superior of the Daughters of St. Paul, my dear brothers and sisters, we are on a historic moment of the 50th death anniversary of our founder, Blessed James Alberione. I welcome all of you to this gathering. Announcing the biblical year of the Pauline family, on the 23rd of January 2020, all the superiors general of the Pauline family sent the following message to all the Pauline communities around the world. Open quote,
Today, January 26th, third Sunday in Ordinary Time, at the end of the Pauline vocation year, in the whole church we celebrate the Sunday of the Word of God, instituted by Pope Francis with the apostolic letter Aperuit Illis. We welcome this invitation as Pauline family, renewing the centrality of the Word of God in our life and in our mission, according to the legacy left to us by our founder, Blessed James Alberione. On this day, we announce that from 26 November 2020 to 26 November 2021, we will celebrate together as Pauline family the year of the Word of God with the theme, so that the Word of the Lord may speed forward. 2 Thessalonians chapter 3, verse 1. The common goal of the biblical year is, on a journey with the church, we renew ourselves through familiarity, study, and prayerful reading of the Holy Scriptures, to live by the Word so that it reaches everyone, especially those in the existential peripheries. The choice of November 26, the anniversary of the heavenly birthday of our founder, Blessed James Alberione, signifies his particular bond with the Word. He too can be defined as a man of the Word of God, tireless and prophetic hearer and apostle. And this renewed centrality of the Word of God, embodied in Jesus' Master, the way, the truth, and the life, the Good Shepherd, will prepare us to remember the 50th anniversary of his death in 2021, end quote. On 30 May 2020, the general governments of the Pauline family released a logo, which you can see there behind the screen there, and a prayer for the biblical year. And following the directives given by the superiors general, the provincial superiors of the Pauline congregations in India set up a core team to plan the celebration of the biblical year of the Pauline family in India. We thus inaugurated the biblical year on the feast day of our founder on 26 November 2020, with a solemn Eucharistic celebration presided over by Father Vergis Nyalian, the provincial superior, which was live-streamed for all Paulines to attend. It was indeed preceded by a Te Deum conducted by Father Devasya Joseph on our founder. On 23rd of January 2021, we organized a webinar on the theme that the Word of God may speed forward. The main speaker of the day was Most Reverend Antony Swami Peter Abir, Chairman CCBA Commission for Bible and Bishop of Sultanbet. During the year, we also organized 8 online lectures on the letters of St. Paul by our very own Bible scholars, Father Augustine, Sister Palsy, Sister Pauline, Sister Antoinette, and Sister Rosalie. We conducted 5 rounds of Bible quiz program for our aspirants, postulants, and novices, essay competition for the perpetually professed members, video skit for junior brothers and sisters, and music competition open to all. In addition to this, several programs were held in local communities of the Pauline family all over India, and of course, around the world. Noteworthy among them in India were the launch of God's Word app by St. Paul's Biblical Center, New Delhi, 10-minute Bible study online lecture on each book of the Bible by St. Paul's Biblical Center, New Delhi, creation of a children's Bible text by St. Paul's Biblical Center, Delhi, launch of free distribution of Bibles in 7 local languages throughout the dioceses of India by the Society of St. Paul, creation of an audio Bible by St. Paul's Multimedia Mumbai. Bible Sunday and Bible Week programs organized by Daughters of St. Paul in dioceses and parishes, distribution of free Bibles and New Testament by Daughters of St. Paul, webinars on the letters of St. Paul on prayer, faith and character formation by the pious disciples of the Divine Master. These are only a few of the various and very many activities we were having during the year. My dear sisters and brothers, scanning through the 107 years of the history of the Pauline family, we learn that a biblical year was celebrated every 30 years. The first one was 1930-31. The second one was 1960-61. The third one was 1990-91. And of course, the fourth one we are in now, 2020-21. In the words of Blessed James Alberione, the purpose of the biblical year and biblical apostolate in the Pauline family is that the Bible be spoken of, the Bible spread, and that in every family enter the Bible. Let it be held in a place of honor. Let it be read with reverence. The diffusion of the sacred scripture must be the first and most important object of all our apostolic activity. We are born from the Word, for the Word, and in the Word. Therefore, we must see to it that all of our books, films, transmissions, records will be always and only an extension, an echo, a follow-up, a radiation of the divine book, but especially of the gospel, end quote from Blessed James Alberione. This, in fact, should not be termed as the end of the closing of the biblical year. We are beginning a new chapter with the Word of God. We Paulines are now filled with new enthusiasm, energy and zeal for the Word of God. We carry on from here with greater motivation, energy and impetus for reading, study and distribution of the Word of God. The message of Don Valdi de Castro, the Superior General of the Society of St. Paul, on this momentous occasion is very appropriate. Open quote, "It is a favorable occasion to renew our commitment to live and proclaim the gospel in creative fidelity to the Pauline charism in the current culture of communication," end quote. With these remarks, it is now my privilege to welcome all of you once again to this family gathering. A very special word of welcome to Most Reverend John Rodriguez, Auxiliary Bishop of Bombay. Bishop John is no stranger to us. In fact, people already started commenting that he is a half Pauline or three-quarter of a Pauline. His association with the Pauline family in our activities, celebrations, and events is very well known. We thank you, Bishop, for your guidance, your very personal and friendly presence in our midst, and a very hearty welcome to you, Bishop John. We also welcome Reverend Father Varghese Nyalian, the Provincial Superior of the Society of St. Paul, Sister Arul Mary Susai, Provincial Superior, Daughters of St. Paul, and Sister Celine Dikuna, Provincial Superior, Pious Disciples of the Divine Master. Sister Celine, along with Sister Palsy, who was a member of the core team organizing this event in the year, came all the way from Bengaluru to be part of this celebration. And therefore, a very, very, very warm and special word of welcome to you, Sister Celine. Along with Sister Palsy, I also welcome Sister Sushma, another member of the core team. We three worked together, and so hearty welcome to you, Sister Sushma. Very hearty welcome to Father Joni SSP, the Superior of the Society of St. Paul, Sister Gracie D'Souza, the Superior of the Pious Disciples of the Divine Master, and Sister Mary Joseph, the Superior of the Daughters of St. Paul, the three Pauline communities in Bandra. Dear brothers and sisters, welcome all of you to this gathering, which is a very informal and very family gathering. I also welcome all the members who are watching us online from all the communities around our country, and also all the Pauline cooperators who are present here and who are watching online from around the country. A very hearty welcome. May Blessed James Alberione, the untiring apostle of the Word of God and the media, continue to inspire, guide, and bless us as we celebrate the 50th year of his heavenly entry. Thank you all, and God bless us all.
Thank you, Father Joe, for your keynote address and warm words of welcome. Like milk and honey, your words have sweetened everyone's ear and warmed each one's heart.
Shiji, the captain announces that we are flying into the galaxy zone over Mumbai.
Is that Salman's galaxy?
Oh no, it is the Pauline star zone. We have with us four luminaries present and shining.
Let's welcome the four stars of the day as they come upon the podium.
Bishop John Rodriguez, the auxiliary bishop and rector of Mount Mary's Shrine.
Sister Adil Mary, provincial of Daughters of St. Paul.
Father Varghese, the provincial superior of Society of St. Paul.
And Sister Celine, provincial superior of Pious Disciples.
Let's give a big round of applause for these great stars of the day.
Father Joni, the superior of the Society of St. Paul, Mumbai, now will welcome our bishop with a colorful banquet and a memento. Bouquet and memento.
Banquet later, not now. Thank you, Father Joni. Father Joe, the director of St. Paul's Biblical Center, New Delhi, will now felicitate Sister Arul Mary, the provincial of Daughters of St. Paul, with the Golden Jubilee Memento on this joyful occasion.
Sister Paul C., one of the noted scripture scholars from the Pauline family and a skilled professor of sacred scripture, will give a floral welcome and a memento to Reverend Father Varghese, the provincial superior of Society of St. Paul.
Indeed, a galaxy around here. Another great Pauline star, Sister Celine de Kerna, Provincial Superior of Pious Disciples of Divine Master, will be felicitated by Sister Sushma, one of the youngest provincial counselors in Daughters of St. Paul. Very simple, but an excellent missionary. The upcoming star welcoming the star of Pauline family, Sister Celine de Kerna. Ladies and gentlemen, these men and women deserve a standing ovation for the endless sacrifice and sleepless nights they spend for the sake of the gospel and for the year of the Bible. Let's put a big round of applause. Thank you.
We thank God for these great leaders who drive the Pauline mission in India and beyond.
There was a bishop behind Alberione's success story. Guess who? Now, whom to give the prize?
So, there is a bishop in Bandra behind the Pauline mission. Guess who?
Bishops are also saint makers. This bishop is a gentle, silent, humble shepherd. I'm not speaking from the iPad, from my heart.
Bishop, your sheep would love to hear from you once again.
I'm glad to be here once again with the Pauline family and share in your joy on this special occasion. It's nice to see all the members of the three congregations here, as well as the Pauline cooperators and other collaborators with you in your mission. I think one of the key ideas of Blessed James Alberione was connectivity. Everything is linked together. Work and prayer, our commitment to the Lord, our service to people, everything knit together. In fact, he says in one place, I think, about Bible, liturgy, and catechetics. So Bible with catechetics and liturgy in it. Liturgy with catechetics and Bible in it. And catechetics with liturgy and the Bible. Everything knit together and bound in this one praise of God. And I think it's significant that all of you as members of the Pauline family interact and gather together on certain occasions and support each other in your ministry, in your apostolate. And may that continue, that Blessed Alberione will guide you and inspire you in new ways. I really admire his vision and foresight in all these matters. And maybe he would invite you to also share and think of the future as new means are open to us, at the same time holding on and strengthening the existing means that you have. This connectivity exists among you, among reaching out then to all the people, and also with the diocese. I think I've been called very often to various programs over here. Obviously, one of the reasons is because I'm nearby. But I think this bond has grown stronger also since our novena at Mount Mary's. When y'all came over there, Father Johnny and team came there to help us with the relay of the novena and the masses right through. So it was a wonderful gesture, an initiative from them. Yeah. And they offered services freely to us so that we could relay the entire novena and the feast masses for 17 days to so many people. And we received a lot of appreciation on that. So thank you, Father Johnny, Sebastian, and all the entire team who worked so hard. That sleepless nights that you all spoke of, and not us, but I think they were the ones who were really engaged in that, so that the word of God could be proclaimed and devotion to our Blessed Mother encouraged. So thank you for that aspect of connectivity. We pray that the Lord will show us the way forward in the midst of all the challenges that we face today. It's remarkable that you've had a year of the Word of God, even during this time of lockdown, two lockdowns and various restrictions. The Word of God cannot be stopped and will continue to be proclaimed, will continue to reach, as long as we are willing to be the Lord's instruments. And may He give us that strength. I'm semi-Pauline or deutro-Pauline, I don't know what. But thank you for that and for your warm welcome and hospitality. May the Lord bless you and Blessed Alberione, St. Paul and Mary, Queen of the Apostles, intercede for all of you. Thank you.
We feel elated and elevated listening to you, dear Bishop. John, the way you speak is the way you talk. The way you speak is the way you walk. May you stay strong and saintly and continue to shepherd the Paulines in and around. Thank you.
Dance is one of the most divine form of arts. It is much more than just moving hands and legs. Dancers are the messengers of the gods.
May I now request the pious disciple sisters, along with their artistic students, to enrich the audience with their biblical and musical steps. Over to you, dear sisters.
bit, beginning with a core team, Father Joe Irapakat, Sister Paul C. Anthony, and Sister Sushma Kullu, who animated and moved the entire Pauline family in India, including the Pauline cooperators, young and old, making them get involved into their best. Hats off to them. Besides, the larger global Pauline family celebration, each community organized programs to make the word come alive in their personal, community, and apostolic levels. I am sure the biblical year has ignited a special passion for God's word in each one of us. I thank God for the inspiration given to our saintly founder, Blessed James Alberione, who handed down to us the word which we are expected to live and give to each one at every home. Gratefully, I acknowledge everyone's effort, and especially the core team, who has carried out their responsibility so efficiently and so meaningfully. My wish and prayer for all of us is that the light of God's word continue to radiate through all aspects of our lives as we carry on our noble mission of giving wings and feet to the gospel. May God bless and guide all of us. And may our blessed founder, whose golden heavenly birth we celebrate, continue to inspire and lead us to fulfill our Pauline charism and its mission. Thank you.
Go a long way, as always. Thank you for your presence today.
Dance?
Yes, we have a long awaited dance now.
The Pious Disciples sisters will be here.
Shall we have a thunderous applause and welcome the Pious Disciples sisters and the students from the dance school?
क्रियात्मक और जीवित है, ये हमारे मार्ग के लिए रोशनी है। इस मार्ग पर चलते हुए हम संचार साधन के माध्यम से ईश वचन के दूत बने। आज हम पोलाइंस को संत पॉलस अपने इन शब्दों से चुनौती देते हैं। धिक्कार मुझे यदि मैं सुसमाचार का प्रचार न करूं। आइए हम संत पॉलस के पुत्र पुत्रियां उनके इस भावनाओं को मन में लेकर एक नृत्य के माध्यम से अपनी सभी प्रेरित गतिविधियों को प्रभु के चरणों में समर्पित करके सबके लिए सब कुछ बन जाए।
Thank you, sisters, for your beautiful and courageous steps brought us joy and the presence of God.
They are from Divya Kala Kendra, from Prathnalaya Pious Double Sisters. We will have their memories for weeks to come. Thank you.
A single conversation across a table with a wise person is worth reading a book.
Also worth selling a book.
Friends, let's listen to the wisdom of this wise Pauline, Reverend Sister Celine, the Provincial of Pious Disciples.
Put your hands together and welcome Sister Celine de Cunha, Provincial Superior of Pious Disciples or Divine Master.
Right, Reverend John Rodriguez, Auxiliary Bishop of Bombay, Reverend Father Vargis Nyalian, Provincial Superior of the Society of St. Paul, Reverend Sister Arul Mary, Provincial Superior of the Daughters of St. Paul, My dear brothers, sisters, fathers, cooperators, and friends of the Divine Master. After having lived the year-long program of the Biblical Year of the Pauline Family, we have now the joy of concluding this fruitful and graceful year. We know some of our community members have begun this year on earth, and they have concluded it in heaven. Kindly allow me to offer my humble and deepest appreciation to every member of the Pauline family. 50 years back, members of the Pauline family said adieu to our beloved founder, Blessed James Alberione. The elderly brothers and sisters who are present here must be having the vivid memory of those days and time. When we enter the living room of our founder in Rome, the clock in his room continued to be motionless at the hour the Lord struck the bell for him to reach heaven. 50 years back, the Pauline family was not developed as for now. The members were few, hence the development in mission was also meager. We have been extremely blessed with our founder, as we have learned and continue to learn the ropes of spiritual and charismatic things. The words of St. Paul, "It is no longer I who live, it is Christ who lives in me," were the driving force of his interior life that resulted in his vast apostolic activity. The legacy that our founder has left behind as Paulines energizes us to proclaim Jesus Master, way, truth, and life to the world through the means of social communication. Many challenges have come along our way to mold us the way we grew as Pauline tree. I believe this molding will bring us out of our shadows day by day. Biblical year of the Pauline family that began on 26th November 2020 with the theme, "The Word of God May Speed Forward," has been a life-enriching and life-enhancing year. As we conclude the year of the Bible, we have ample reason to be grateful for. I am glad to express my words of appreciation to the team, core team, that has worked tirelessly to put up various programs throughout the year. The aim of the Pauline Biblical Year for our founder, Blessed James Alberione, was to give the Bible. It is the centerpiece of Pauline apostolate. We as Pauline family have brought up tremendous toil to reach the Word of God far and wide, especially during this grace-filled year. Bible Year of the Pauline family was celebrated even in the time of our founder. But over the years, we have made a lot of progress in using the modern means to be effective to reach to the people. May the efforts taken, the distance covered in unfolding the Word of God, may yield fruit in due season. May our journey with the church renew us familiarity, study, and prayerful reading of sacred scripture, which in turn will make us live and spread the message of love to every corner of the earth. Along with every PDDM sister, I extend my heartfelt gratitude to God for our founder and for this Pauline Biblical Year 2020 to 2021. May our founder, James Alberione, continue to become the channel of many blessings for all the Pauline sisters and brothers. May God continue to shower his graces upon us, that we may realize the dream of our founder in making known to the world the way, the truth, and the life. Thank you.
Thank you, dear sister. Celine, indeed we feel, after listening to you, we have read not just one book, but volumes of books. Thank you for your inspiring and visionary words, sister. Hey, Shuji, all work and no play makes Jack a dull boy.
Oh, yes. Let's call the Dancing Daughters of St. Paul to steal the show.
Let's welcome these atomic daughters of St. Paul, Alberian daughters of St. Paul, to rock the day.
Blessed James Alberione was born in a family of farmers in 1884 in San Lorenzo di Fasano, Alba, Italy. Little James, the youngest of his brothers, would accompany them in the evening in the fields, carrying a little kerosene lamp to light up the way for them. Tired and sleepy from trying to keep up with his brothers, he would often hear his mother cry out, "James, give them light, James. Hey, James, give them light." Was this the voice of God calling James to bring light into his dark world? Was this the voice of Christ the Master, who knew that James would later be a bearer of his light?
Just a poor little farmer's son, born frail.
like to be. Though he was still so young, I'll be a priest, said he. And then at only age, he took his first communion, the light of God in union. He received, take you the vow.
James, James, give them light. This call comes again powerfully on 31st December 1900 at night. After 4 hours of adoration before the Blessed Sacrament exposed in the Cathedral of Alba, James, in the spirit of St. Paul, welcomed the call to bring humanity to God and God to humanity using the most modern means of communication.
You're wrong. There are only three, four popes.
Pope Francis.
Who said? Someone said Pope Francis here.
Here also said Pope Francis.
Sister Amita, get a gift voucher from Tidal Waves from Father Francisco. Today, 50 years after Alberione's death, thousands of Paulines are spread in 70 countries over 5 continents, confirming his vision and mission.
Here we have young Paulines who have showcased their talents like Alberione in the digital world.
They have spent time and energy and participated in all the contests during the Pauline year of the Bible and have won laurels.
Over to Sister Sushma and Father Joe, the organizing leaders of the Pauline year of the Bible, to recognize and award these zealous young Paulines.
Dear friends, may I have your attention, please? Thank you. This is the joyous moment for which we had been waiting for patiently. This is the time we acknowledge the talent of our winners who have taken much effort and expressed their love for the Word of God by participating in various competitions throughout the biblical year of the Pauline family 2020-21. I believe all the members of the Pauline family, young and old, have actively participated in all the events. I greatly appreciate their perseverance and constancy. So let us celebrate and cheer our winners. I now invite Bishop John Rodrigues to come on the stage and give away the prizes. We had Bible quiz competition for the aspirants, postulants, and novices. So for the aspirants, the second prize goes to aspirant Roshanti Dungdung, Daughters of St. Paul, Bangalore. The first prize goes to Sarojini Soreng, Daughters of St. Paul, Bangalore. We had Bible quiz competition for the postulants. The second prize goes to Christine Emmanuel, Society of St. Paul, Vijayawada. They are not here, so anyone can come and take the prizes.
The offer is open, please come and grab. One who comes will get 30% of the prize money.
And the first prize goes to Sushita Kispota, Pious Disciples of the Divine Master, Calicut. We had for the novices as well. So the second prize obtained by, we have two winners, Asmita Dinakar, PDDM, Mysore, and Rowena Silvas Patil, PDDM, Mysore.
They don't look like novices.
And first prize goes to Sharolin Rodrigues, PDDM, Mysore.
So many prizes for the sister.
We had essay writing competition for the perpetually professed. So we have a second prize goes to Sister Mary Gracelet, Pious Disciples of the Divine Master, Bengaluru. And the first prize goes to Sister Shalini Rose, Daughters of St. Paul, Shillong.
You took take the prize and send them WhatsApp.
We had another interesting competition, video skit competition. Any guess for the prizes? Only three members are there, so two will get. On the second place, we have Society of St. Paul Juniors, Bengaluru.
He's the junior most priest here.
And the first prize goes to Daughters of St. Paul Juniors, Bengaluru. We had music competition, lyrics writing, composing music and singing, making it a video recording. So we have on the second place, anyone want to guess? Daughters of St. Paul. You are right, Bishop. Daughters of St. Paul, Bengaluru. And we have on the first place, Pious Disciples of the Divine Master, Bengaluru.
I think we have to send a truckload of prizes to Bengaluru. Oh, Sister Celine is willing to carry.
Thank you, Reverend Bishop. I, on behalf of the core team, thank all the participants for your collaboration and patience. Congratulations to you all. Let this be our spirit. Winning doesn't always mean being first. Winning means you are doing better than you have ever done before. Can we join our hands once again and give a thunderous applause for our winners? Thank you.
Congratulations, dear winners. You are the rock on which the Pauline mission shall be built.
Founder had an avid love for filmmaking. We too have some Paulines who are good filmmakers and artists. Here we present before you a couple of prize-winning entries by Paulines in formation.
May I request Father Francis to screen the two prize-winning films?
The first prize-winning short video skit by Daughters of St. Paul Juniors, again, Bengaluru.
Love cannot be explained, but it ought to be expressed and experienced. The love of God is manifested to us through His Son Jesus, who came into the world as a sacrifice for our sins and to give life. Love Goes On is one such story as we live through this pandemic. Honey, so early today?
Yeah, dear. I'm not feeling too well, so I took leave for half a day.
I told you several times not to go out at this pandemic situation, and you never listened to me. See now what happened.
What are you talking about? Do you think I was simply roaming?
I'm fed up of your meaningless explanation.
Will you please leave me alone? I need to rest a little.
Why are you shouting like this? I'm sorry. Okay, take care. We need to be safe from this corona.
Hello? Yes, doctor. Oh, is it? Okay, doctor. But my children are at home. It's not good to stay home. Please do the formalities for admitting me in the hospital. I will be there this evening. Honey, the result is positive. I'm going to be admitted in the hospital. Please call your mother and ask her to stay with you. Take care.
You never listen to me. See now, you are affected. I don't know what to do.
Hey, don't worry, all right? I'm going to be fine. All the more, I'm going to my friend Dr. Jason's hospital. He will take care of me. Take care of yourself and our children. Sister, how is Mr. John?
Doctor, I checked his pulse. He was okay yesterday, but today his pulse is decreasing and he struggles to breathe. Better to inform his family members.
No, let us wait. I will consult Dr. Mark Twin. He is his family doctor.
Mr. John, how are you? What are you busy with?
Hello, sister. I am watching the prayer service conducted by the Sisters of Daughters of St. Paul. It is consoling. I feel much better. It is nice to see that these sisters are praying for the people who are affected by this COVID-19. You know, not only are these sisters working with media, but they also have the tradition of giving charity and showing love to the needy. I heard Sister Madhuri narrating an incident from their co-founders, Mother Tekla's life.
It is said that in the year 1943, 21st October, she welcomed into our generalate in Rome 26 Benedictine nuns who have been forced by the war to leave the monastery at Monte Cassino. They remained for a year with them. They were looked after well.
Oh, that is also a part of their mission. Praying for the people who are sick.
This is a wonderful mission. Serving and praying for the sick and the needy.
That sounds great.
Please, when will Dr. Jason come?
He is on the way. You can meet him soon.
Thank you. That's very kind of you.
Hi, John. How do you feel today?
Not bad. But I would like to tell you something that is very personal. A secret.
Oh, that's interesting. What's that?
I'm aware of my sickness. And I know how badly I am affected by this virus. And I have other health issues too. My days are numbered and I don't want to be a burden to my family. I have even earned more than enough for my children and my wife. They can live happily with the money that I have saved for them. The only thing that they will miss is me, and I'll miss them too.
Hey, what nonsense are you talking? You'll be all right, man.
Hey, Jason, listen to me. When I was watching the prayer service of those sisters, I was really moved. I wanted to do something for other people.
And what is that?
I wanted to donate my eyes after I leave this world. God so loved me and He gave me life and everything that I was in need of in this life. In return, I want to give my eyes to someone that they may have sight and live. By this very act, I feel happy because I share the love of God.
I am so sad to know that you have reached this stage of your life, but I am really proud of you.
Thank you. Please take care of my children.
John shared the love of God by donating his eyes to Jacqueline. Jacqueline now sees the creation through the eyes of Mr. John. The sacrificial love of Jesus continues through you and me. We all have a call to love, a love that goes on.
Put your hands together for Daughters of St. Paul, Bangalore. Not just prize-winning entry, it could be even Oscar-winning entry. You've done still with all effects. Thank you, dear sisters. Very, very meaningful. The next prize-winning entry for the best winning album for lyrics, music and singing goes to Pious Disciples of Divine Master Sisters, again from? Bangalore. You're right, Bangalore. Let's see the prize winning entry. For the beautiful hymn led by Sister Gracelet, again from Bengaluru, they tell us Paulines have a great future. Also, I want to inform that St. Paul's also live streams 30 holy minutes every day. Many of them are getting healed. We get reports every day on a daily basis. Pauline is always new, novel, and next. A Pauline is also humble, yet scrutinizing the signs of the times, always. Here's a surprise declaration of ABQ to all Paulines, and yes, to the church in digital age.
ABQ? Hey, Reynold, what is it?
Father Joe, let the baby out. ABQ.
Can anyone say what is the acronym for ABQ? Baby is not out. A stands for? B for? Q for? Alberione Bible Quiz. A, B, Q. I stand in front of you not as a member of the team organizing the Bible year, but as someone working in the Biblical Center in Delhi. We have designed a new project called ABQ, Alberione Bible Quiz, and we thought today is the most auspicious occasion to launch this program. This is launched on the 50th death anniversary of our founder, Blessed James Alberione. In his honor, in his name, and with his blessings. So ABQ for Blessed Alberione. I especially thank Father Vargis, our provincial, and Father Sebastian, the director of apostolate, for proposing this and also giving us full support to launch this program. Thanks also to the Council for Apostolate who have been behind us, supporting us and encouraging us, giving us suggestions. And a very special word of thanks to Brother Thomas EJ, our technician. Bishop knows him because he was on Mount Mary for the live streaming of the feast. Brother Thomas is the man behind this, especially in the technical aspects. He has done a lot of research and he has come up with a very workable format for this ABQ. So we hope and pray that this is a new project launched on the feast of our blessed founder with his blessings will become a national event. More about it will be there in a promo video that we will be showing right now. With the permission of all of you, I request Bishop John to launch ABQ by switching on the promo video. I request Father Vargis, sisters, both of you, and Father Sebastian, our director of apostolate, to flank the bishop as he launches this.
Bible regularly and in a systematic way. 100 questions over rupees 3 lakhs in prizes to be won. Two categories of participants. Group 1, those up to 18 years of age. Group 2, those above 19 years of age. And the best part is, register for free today by clicking the link below. Spread this good news around by forwarding it to your friends, relatives and social media contacts. Begin your reading and study of the Bible today. The first round will be held on the first Sunday of Lent on 6th March 2022 at 5 p.m. Once again, welcome to Alberione Bible Quiz from St. Paul's Biblical Center. Happy reading of the Word of God and happy quiz time. Thank you.
Thank you, Father Joe and your team. Now the baby is out. Let us nurse, let us feed, and make it grow and glow.
The vibration of gratitude attracts more positive things in our life because it comes from our heart.
I would now like to call upon Sister Dr. Paul C. to render her words of gratitude and begin a new journey to the next, to the novel and to the new. Sister Paul C.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. A pleasant afternoon to one and all. I consider it a great privilege to propose a vote of thanks on this auspicious occasion of the Poland family. United with the Poland family across the globe, we thank God Almighty for the gift of our beloved founder, James Alberione, to the church and to us, whose 50th anniversary of the birth to heaven, which we celebrate today with gratitude and praise. It was indeed a time of grace to the entire Poland family as we dedicated the year, starting from 26th November 2020 to 26th November 2021, as a biblical year of the Poland family, with the theme that the word of God may speed forward, taken from 2 Thessalonians chapter 3, 1. We are indeed happy to have our special guest, Right Reverend John Rodriguez, Auxiliary Bishop of Mumbai, amidst us, and for having solemnized the occasion with the Eucharistic celebration and his thought-provoking homily, especially, I would word it, passion and continuous prayer. And above all, for his love for the Poland family, as he rightly expressed, half Poland. Thank you, dear Bishop John. Deep sense of gratitude, we recall the three provincial superiors of Poland family in India, Reverend Father Verghese Nalian, Society of St. Paul, Reverend Sister Arul Mary Suse, daughter of St. Paul, and Sister Celine Kuna, PDDM. And also we would like to remember former provincial of PDDM, who was with us begin this year of the Bible, Sister Rosemary Mutacheril, for their encouragement, contributions, and wholehearted support during the biblical year and this beautiful occasion. We remain grateful to you, dear superiors. A big applause to the local organizing team, Father Francis Xavier, Society of St. Paul, the coordinator, Father Renold Pascal, Society of St. Paul, Sister Amida Mascarinas, PDDM. Sister Bibiana, PDDM. Sister Naomi, Daughters of St. Paul. Sister Ada Dorothy, Daughters of St. Paul, for their tireless efforts in making these celebrations a meaningful and commendable one. Let us give them a great applause. A special thanks to Sister Amida, Sister Bibiana, Celine, and team for their melodious choir, which raised our hearts to God today. Sister Naomi, Sister Dorothy, DSP, and team, who for their flower arrangement and all other altar decorations, and MC of the day, Father Ronald, Society of St. Paul, and Sister Shiji, DSP, you have done a great work. Thank you. We are thankful to the animators and formators for following the program proposed by the team with enthusiasm, especially the webinars on the letters to St. Paul. We appreciate the enthusiasm of the formies on the letters of St. Paul and all the Bible quiz they participated with determination and commitment. Thanks to all who participated in different competitions like essay writing, music competition, and video competition. Let us give them a great clap. Sincere thanks to all the resource persons of the Poland family who put their keen interest in studying and presenting the webinars well. We would like to remember on this occasion Reverend Dr. Peter Abir, Bishop of Sultanpet and Apostolic Administrator of Pondicherry and Cuddalore, for his great contribution in the inauguration function. Also, we remember Reverend Dr. Augustine Kanchikuri, Society of St. Paul, Dr. Sister Pauline Chakalakal, DSP, Sister Rosalie and Sister Antoinette, DSP, for their great contribution during this year. Thanks to all who made this grace-filled biblical year and 50th death anniversary of our founder a colorful one by their thematic dances, video presentations. Special thanks go to Sister Sushma, PDDM, and her troupe. And to our dear aspirants and postulants of Debtors of St. Paul, let us give them a big applause. Thanks to all those who actively participated wholeheartedly in all the programs and particularly in all the competitions. Congratulations to the winners of the Bible Year programs. We really appreciate your hard work. My sincere thanks to Father Sebastian Thomas, who designed the memento, and Sister Naomi and Dorothy for designing the invitation card and bookmarks. Father Francis Xavier and Brother Blaise, who printed the bookmark, and grateful to all of you for the beautiful work that you have done. My thanks will not be complete if I do not acknowledge Father Verghese, who generously offered the venue for today's program. A big applause to Father Verghese. We specially thank Father Johnny, the Superior of Society of St. Paul, Bandra, Father Sebastian Thomas, and Mr. Jefferson for facilitating the live streaming of today's program. Our sincere appreciation and thanks to Mr. Anthony Gomez and team of backyard lawn caterers for the delicious food that awaits us. We are happy and thankful to the entire Poland family in India and abroad for making the biblical year of the Poland family a memorable and grace-filled one by your collaboration, participation and contribution in different levels. Thanks. A note of thanks to all those who are present here today, the members of the Poland family, Poland cooperators and friends, well-wishers, and those who are participating in this program from all over the world. You have been a source of strength to us through your prayers and valuable presence. In case, if I have missed to mention anyone to whom we owe our gratitude, I take this opportunity to appreciate and thank God for your valuable contribution in the success of this beautiful program. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you. Thank you, dear Sister Palsy, for that beautiful and comprehensive gratitude, and your words makes a lot of meaning to the Paulines here. There's someone who has not yet spoken. Guess who? I know you are hungry. Before you get angry, I call upon Father Varghese, the father of the Pauline family in India, Great Britain, and Ireland.
My dear Bishop and my dear friends, I don't want to talk too much because this morning when I saw the program sheet, I asked what happened. My name is not there. Then Father Joe told me, ever since the pandemic began, you have been talking too much. Too many circulars and too many restrictions. So at least today you please leave us free. We don't want to hear too much from your talk again today. My dear friends, I think I'll be very cruel if I do not speak today. Particularly, I think Folsi has thanked everybody else, except the core team. Core team headed by Joe and Sushma and Sister Palsy. All that has happened during this last 1 year are things meticulously planned and designed by them. As provincial superiors, we were there just to listen to them now and then, and add if there is. Practically, we had nothing more to add to what they had already designed. And I myself personally saw many of the programs were participated by most of our communities in full numbers, because we could see the visuals online. So hats off to Joe and Sushma and Palsy for the wonderful work. Well done. Thank you so much on behalf of all of us present here, all the Pauline family here in India. And I pray that this spirit continues. And the spirit of our founder, James Alberione, animate each one of us. Thank you so much. Have a nice day. Enjoy the rest of the day. Thank you.
Alberionian, the marvel of our times, calls his sons and daughters to march ahead courageously into the digital times.
Thank you, Father Varghese, for icing the cake today. Thanking the core team who was the engine behind this celebration today. As Pauline apostles, let us rise, united in love and zeal, to sing the Pauline anthem led by Sister Amita, Pious Disciples of Divine Master, and her team.
Praise to the Father and to the Son. Found spread the gospel to everyone. For this, O gracious Lord, you chose blessed James Alberione. Oh, we praise. Not afraid, I am with you. From the tabernacle giving you strength, chosen are you to go and proclaim by means of the most modern media. I am the Alpha and Omega, true, the only way, truth and life. Follow my steps, renew and grow in the charism of your founder. Praise to the Father and to the Son and to the Spirit, three in one. Trinity eternal, all divine, we praise and thank for foundation.
Thank you, dear sister Amita and your team, for this beautiful Pauline anthem. And for all of our information, this anthem was created and written by Brother James Upani, who is present over here. And also, I'd like to recognize Father Alfonso, who had a very thirst for the Word of God, who was instrumental in promoting the Bible, 800 copies of Marathi Bible, 500 copies of Hindi Bible, and 200 copies of English Bible, along with the community of Society of St. Paul, Mumbai, with Father Johnny. Let us put our hands together for Alfonso and Father Johnny and the team.
The best and beautiful things in the world cannot be seen or even touched. They must be felt by heart.
Now, let's all enjoy the Pauline festive meal.
Relishing our relationships.
Dissolving our differences.
Permeating our Pauline spirit in this meal of love.
Let's go to the Pauline delicious festive meal down in our refectory. Thank you, one and all, for being patient
Thank you.
With us. And God Thank bless you, all of us.